said that the blacksmith.
Something like this is our R to the N, and you will
So what does this mean? This simply means to take all of the homomorphic sections that are L2 enough spaces are held. There is a certain mention. Okay, and then is the second magic, or maybe depends on you. a long time to figure this out. But now you see that we have the two magic together. We know that the RLH, although it is not a ring, it lies in the plural of rings, and we know how to define the occupant bodies of the plural of the ring in the plural of the rings. And we have the definition of the occupant bodies. So finally, we come to the most important definition here. The partial occupant body Berta of the Hermitian line model is defined as the occupant body of RLH. Okay, so this is our definition. So far, any questions?
Yes, very impressive. Yeah. Seems to me that the hardest part is the first theorem. That says,
yeah.
That says that it is almost correct.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah,
so roughly speaking, you can imagine that in the case of analytic similarities, this is not very hard. And then in the case of in the general case, you make use of some domain approximation to prove that. But of course, this is just a very simplified version of the proof, and you're right, there are many difficulties.
Is it just, well, it's very naive, but seriously, you don't use the relation to like an infinity version of a multiply and shift?
In the general case, if you have a singular metric, then it can happen that the infinity version of the multiply prediction is trivial. So it doesn't help much in the distribution. But in the case of analytic similarities, I do make use of the L infinity version of the Markov vector sheaf to prove that it is almost the ring.
Okay.
Yeah.
You really need the approximation.
Yeah, you do. Okay, now we can come back to the main properties of the bodies. And I begin 10 minutes late, right? So I still have 8 minutes to go.
30 to go.
Okay. Originally, for the on this part, I have occupant bodies. On this part, I read something about partial occupant bodies. Originally, the theorem of Lazarsfield and Mustasov says that Hertha L depends only on the numerical class in the demonstrability group. That means there's writing simply like this. And on this side, we have a similar result. Theta mu L H. Its dependence on H is only on the I singularity type of H. And what do I mean by that? Suppose that we have two different singular metrics, H and H prime. We say that they are I equivalent if all of their Markov reductions are equal. For any A. This is by definition this is the definition of the I equivalence. And it turns out that this reflects the property of the I singularity type of H. And another theorem, main theorem about occupant bodies is the theorem of Jell, which says that theta mu L.
But what do you mean by the singularity? I mean, are you in the second column, are you fixing the line model?
Yeah, I'm fixing the line model, yeah. Okay. I'm only talking about the dependence on the metric H.
Okay.
And the second main theorem is the theorem of Jell. The collection of occupant bodies determines the numerical class in N1 in its numerical class. And in our setting, the corresponding result is the following. The collection for all mu determines the I singularity type of H. You can read this? Yeah. Okay, so you see that in the partial occupant body setting, we have complete analog of the theorems in the Euro occupant body setting. And we it's by definition the intersection of all of the URL optical bodies of the components of the D divisor. And in some sense, the URL optical bodies, they are more or less computable. At least in the case of surfaces, you know how to compute them. In the general case, they are well studied. So in that case, I can really say that these things are computable. And the last term is just a vector, a fixed vector in Rn, and they can be computed in multiple ways. And so in some sense, the partial optical bodies, although it is defined in the abstract way, more concretely, it can be computed in terms of the URL optical bodies and up to a translation, of course.
So the second term doesn't affect the volume, for example?
Sorry, what is it?
The second term doesn't affect the volume.
No, it doesn't affect volume at all. Just the translation. Indeed. Okay, and together with Xu, we are actually trying to compute the partial optical bodies in the case of universal elliptic curve with some level structure for interplanetary. And it seems like it is possible to compute the partial optical bodies with this method. In that case, we have a very good understanding of the D-divisors. expect that or not. But in principle,